If we want to show India on a map, then how can we show? Or if we want to show the world or any continent on a map, then how can we show that? But because the actual region is very large, so India has a very large region, then how can we show the large regions on the map? So then we usually choose a scale, and even for every map, the choose will be shown on the bottom of the map. Then for example, on the map, if you take 1 centimeter, then the actual distance will be, for example, 8 kilometers. Means the actual distance on the map is 8 kilometers, then we will choose 1 centimeter on the map. So this map means it is the miniature representation of very large regions. Means we are minimizing the actual region and we are showing on the map. So here, for example, if you want to show India on this map, for example, from the distance between two points is 8 kilometers, then we will show only 1 centimeter on the map. So we are choosing a scale. So here 8 kilometers may be 10 kilometers or it may be 100 kilometers, but as per our convenience, we are choosing the values. Now 1 centimeter equals to 8 kilometers means 8 into 1000 meters. This equals to 8000 meters, and we can convert meters into centimeters, and again 8000. So 1 meter equals to 100 centimeters. So this equals to into 100 centimeters. Here 8 ones are 8. So this is 8 lakh. Here if the actual length of the any region is 8 lakh centimeters, then we are taking as 1 centimeter on the map. So this scale represents here 1 centimeter equals to 8 lakh centimeter. This scale represents that if the distance between any two points on the actual region is 8 lakh centimeters, then we are taking 1 centimeter on the map. If the actual distance is, for example, 16 lakhs centimeters, then what is the length on the map? So that is obviously 8 to the 16, so we can take that 1 to the 2 centimeters. If the length on the map between two points is 5 centimeters, then what is the actual distance between those two points on the actual region? So then what is this? So here 1 is multiplied by 5. So here also 8 is multiplied by 5. 8 5 are 40 lakhs centimeters. So choosing a convenient scale, so we will draw the maps which has very larger areas. Now let us solve few problems in direct proportion. Now here car parking charges are given that, so for 4 hours the charge is 60 rupees and for 8 hours the charge is 100 rupees, 12 hours 140 rupees and 24 hours 180 rupees. Now let us check that the car parking charges are direct proportion to the parking time or not. Now let us take the first case. In the first case, the ratio between two quantities 4 by 60 equals to 4 ones are 4, 4 15 are 60, this equals to 1 by 5. The ratio between these two quantities is 1 by 15. So if you take this is x and this is y. So if you take x1 by y1, 4 by 16, that equals to 1 by 15. Now the second case 8 by 100, so x2 by y2 will take now. Now here we can cancel that, 4 2s are 8 and 4 25s are 100, this equals to 2 by 25. And if you observe the third case, 12 by 140 means x3 by y3 equals to 12 by 140. Now here we can cancel two table, 2 6 are 12 and 2 7 are 14, 0, again 2 3 are 6, 2 35. So this equals to 3 by 35. So here x1 by y1 is not equal to x2 by y2 and this is not equal to x3 by y3. So the ratio between two quantities means the ratio between the first quantity and the second quantity is not a constant in all the cases. So we can say that x is not directly proportional to y, or the car parking charges are not direct proportion to the parking time. Now let us see the next question. A machine in a soft drink factory fills 840 bottles in 6 hours. How many bottles will it fill in 5 hours? So we can observe that there are two quantities in this question. The first quantity is number of bottles filled and the second quantity is time taken. So we will take these two quantities in a table, that the first row of the table is number of bottles filled and time taken in hours. Now it will fill 840 bottles in 6 hours. Now in the second case, how many bottles will it fill? So we don't know this value. Let us take it x, then in 5 hours let the number of bottles to be filled in 5 hours be x. Now if it is taking 6 hours to fill 840 bottles, then it will take less time to fill the less bottles, or it will take less time to take less bottles. Now if it is filling 840 bottles in 6 hours, then how many bottles will it fill in 5 hours? So the time is reduced here, so even the number of bottles to be filled also reduced. Now if one quantity decreases, then the other quantity also decreases, such that the ratio between these two quantities remains a constant. So this is the case of direct proportion. So we can write that this is a case of direct proportion. So in direct proportion, the ratio between two quantities remains a constant. So here we can write that 840 divided by 6 equals to x divided by 5. Now by cross multiplication we can write that 6 into x equals to 840 into 5. Now this equals to x equals to 840 into 5 divided by 6. Now we can cancel with 6 table here, 6 1s are 6, 6 1s are 6, 6 4s are 24, 0. Then x equals to, so 140 into 5, 14 5 are 70, 0. Therefore, it will fill 700 bottles in 5 hours. Therefore, the machine will fill 700 bottles in 5 hours. Now let us solve the next question. A loaded truck travels 14 kilometers in 25 minutes. So the truck is traveling 14 kilometers in 25 minutes. Now, if the speed remains the same, means it is maintaining the constant speed, then how far can it travel in 5 hours? So, what is the distance covered by the truck in 5 hours? So, yeah, the two quantities are there. One is the distance traveled or the distance covered by the truck and the time taken. So, here also these two quantities are in direct proportion. Now, what we have to find, how far can it travel? The distance covered by the truck B, x kilometers. Now let us draw the table to understand easily. Now distance covered and time taken. So distance covered you will take in kilometers, and the time taken you will take in minutes. Now the first, when it travels 14 kilometers, then it is taking 25 minutes. Then here it is maintaining the constant speed, so the speed remains the same. Then it is, how far can it travel in 5 hours? So here it is given that 5 hours, but it is to be converted into minutes. So 5 into 60 equals to 300 minutes. Then how much can it travel? You should find the distance traveled by the truck. So you will take, that is x kilometers. Now if it is taking 25 minutes, then it is traveling 14 kilometers. So if it is taking 300 minutes, means more time, then definitely it will travel more kilometers when it maintains the same speed. Means this is a case of direct proportion. Here the distance covered is direct proportional to the time taken. So here we can write, this is a case of direct proportion. So in direct proportion we know that the ratio between two quantities will be a constant. So we can take 14 by 25 equals to x by 300. Now by cross multiplication we can write that x into 25 equals to 14 into 300. Now x equals to 14 into 300 by 25. Now we can cancel 25 and 300. So here 25 ones are 25, 25 ones are 25, 5 is the remainder here, 50, 25 twos are 50. Now x equals to 14 into 12. So 14 twos are 28, 14 ones are 14 plus 2, 16, 168 kilometers. Therefore the truck travels 168 kilometers in 300 minutes, means in 5 hours. Therefore the truck travels 168 kilometers in 5 hours.
If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. Please subscribe to our channel to get more videos on CBSE syllabus.